one of the main issues that we're dealing with as an organization is fair competition. What we saw during the pandemic was that smaller family-owned businesses like ours had a more difficult time getting supplied than some of our national, really well-funded counterparts. There are all kinds of issues associated with that, but we want to make sure that our industry, particularly the independent industry, people like us, can continue to operate and thrive in the future. You know, whether it's our business or some of our suppliers, sourcing material, having the labor to produce the material, continues to be an issue, even though we're, you know, 2 years post-pandemic or since the pandemic started.
I also think food safety plays a role. Look at the baby formula shortage. The supply chain issue was already in danger for these factors, but we saw the brunt of it in regards to contamination. But I don't see the supply chain issues easing soon. We are seeing companies think outside the box to find solutions and adapt to the issues, but I think it's going to be a while until we're back to where we were pre-pandemic. I believe the labor shortage is worse than the supply chain issue. Companies have been inventive when it comes to supply chain issues, finding alternative sources for items or reaching beyond their normal procurement sphere to find solutions. But while companies can and should be creative in their hiring, the fact is there simply aren't enough people to fill the vacancies.
So creating a culture where we have a high degree of trust, where people can work well together, is the foundation of our company. Because of that, I think that we were able to retain and create an environment for our employees that they felt safe in, and were able to meet the needs of the customer.
What advice would you give that small grocery store that's trying to fill their employee base?
Yeah, so I have a firm belief that you really hire for the person's attitude. A lot of what we do, we can teach, you know, but we can't really teach their attitude and how they fit within our culture. So make sure I know what your culture is about, and make sure you're hiring people to that culture.
Some tips for grocers to help them find long-term employees. I would start off by ensuring that they're participating in specific wage and benefit surveys to ensure they're staying competitive in the market. I would encourage them to conduct employee engagement surveys to find out exactly what their employees want when it comes to benefits and wages. Sometimes employers are pleasantly surprised that wages are not the number one reason why employees stay long-term at companies. So if they can find out what their employees want, a lot of times they can use those answers to ensure they're keeping their employees long-term. There's definitely a correlation between employee experience and the effects of the labor shortage on a company. Many employee engagement surveys will show employers that employee experience is sometimes more important than actual wages. And so an employer needs to ensure that their employees are having positive experiences within their workplace.
Costs are going up in just about every category. Yes. And so our approach has really been to try to manage those increases as best we can. So we're trying to be creative. For instance, through logistics, we were facing, you know, double-digit increases in costs and logistics. By analyzing and figuring out how we can make it more efficient, we're actually going to see a little bit of a decrease this year in our logistics costs.
Some larger stores have a tendency to get a lion's share of a lot of those products. What advice would you give to those small grocery stores when it comes to those struggles and challenges with the supply chain? And oftentimes it's, well, I should have done more sooner. Yep. I should have had better relationships, but I'm just curious from your perspective, you know, what would you recommend?
I think, first of all, and you mentioned it, relationships. This is still, even though this is, you know, we're dealing with a big businesses, some of our, you know, whether, you know, some of the big CPG companies, these are big businesses, but at the end of the day, it's still a relationship business. And the more you get to know your suppliers, the closer you can get to them, Then I think when you have pressures like we felt during the pandemic, you rely on those relationships to help you with your supply. And so keep fighting. Okay. Don't stop.
Okay.
Develop those relationships, value those relationships, and don't stop fighting. You know, yeah. When the pandemic hit and we were having a hard time getting supplied, we were on the phone constantly fighting to get that product.
Yeah, I would always tell people, if you're trying to create a relationship during the pandemic, it's probably too late
yeah.
at that point.
And I think that's true also with your workforce as well.
Agreed. Yeah.
I mean, the benefit of having a great culture is once the pandemic hit, the trust that we had built with our employees allowed us to work through that pandemic and keep our morale high. You couldn't have built that culture once a pandemic started.
Right.
You have to do that ahead of time. So building relationships both with your workforce, your team members, and your suppliers, I think is something that you need to do all the time.